please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Welcome back. The pre-opening rates are here and the Nifty is down 150 points. Vakrangee and PC Jewelers are two stocks which are still down about 10%, but that's of course for the broader market. So just may want to keep an eye on both these names as well. But in terms of index stocks, what is interesting is that some of the stronger stocks, erstwhile stronger stocks, are falling. Like we've already spoken about Maruti, that's down another 4%. Eicher Motors, ICICI, IndusInd Bank. So look like we are in for a rough start. ONGC is up about 4%. I don't know if there's any reason, but others clearly taking a bit of a tumble right now.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, big losses coming in for Vakrangee, PC Jewelers, etc. But a couple of stocks on the upside as well. I don't know if they'll react on the upside, but they could perhaps outperform. Tata Global Beverages, good numbers. United Breweries, the volume growth of 6% was good. So not so bad, about 1-2% cuts is what we're seeing over there. But let's do one thing. For now, let's wait for the market to settle a bit and let's get some ideas out of the way. VK Sharma of HDFC Securities joins in. Vinod, hi, good morning. After the kind of fall that we saw on Friday, what's the most prudent strategy? Not just for the day, but also for the week?
Yeah. Good morning, Sonia, Anuj, and Lata. I think, on Friday, we had the worst advance decline ratio in about 8 years. And tomorrow, today, the things aren't going to be as bad. But definitely, there's not a time to buy. Because in a falling market, there are no holy cows. Stocks which haven't fallen now may fall sometimes later. So I think investors should protect their portfolio. And the larger thing, wherever you want to buy, I think one of the sectors which I feel is good, where people could buy at lower levels, is the insurance sector, because this is a sector where the FIs really don't have the kind of position which they want to build for the longer term, and they'll be willing buyers at lower levels. Having said that, I have ACC, L&T Finance, and ICICI Bank, where investors need to protect. In ACC, I'm suggesting to buy the 1660 put at around 24. Keep a stop loss at 16 and a target of 40 if you want to trade in that. Otherwise, we see the stock falling to around 1580. It's 200 support, so you can continue to hold on to the puts that you buy. In L&T Finance, that is a stock that closed below its 200 moving average. So first time after April 2016. So this could also fall to around 138. So I'm suggesting to buy the 155 put at 4.5 or whatever the price is at the open. And if you want to trade, stop loss at 3 and target around 10. ICICI Bank is a stock which I hold, but definitely a stock where I'd like to recommend buying a put at 330 at buy around 8, stop loss at 5, target of 15. But this stock could take support only around 200 moving average, which is around 297. And the stock that I want to buy is obviously ICICI Pru, where the 200-day moving average, 20-day moving average, and the other moving averages also hover between 2015 and 415 and 417. So yesterday, the 415 call quoted at 420 call quoted around 13, quoted around 15. So I'm buying this. Should it fall to 13 with a stop loss at 8 and a target around 22? So I don't think this will break the 200 moving average. This is one stronger stock among the stocks, other large cap stocks.
Okay, thank you very much, Vinod, for joining us. Let's also quickly get the commodity views on the table. Manisha Gupta joins us. Morning, Manisha.
Morning, Lata. Thank you for that. Well, the commodities have started Asia on a back foot today. You have the strength in US dollar, which is back. The US jobs data on Friday saw the fastest pace in last 8 years, and that, of course, has been supportive. So starting with the crude oil prices, down more than 1% and trading at a one-month lows is how we are on to that. Apart from the strength in US dollar, this is about the US production, which is touching 10 million barrels per day, very close to the other major producers like Saudi Arabia and, of course, Russia as well. But if you look at the banks' reports, they continue to put the crude oil prices revision on the higher side. So the Morgan Stanley, JP Morgan, Goldman Sachs are all putting the crude oil prices around 75 to 82 on the higher side in coming next 6 months. And that is keeping the speculative monies bang on in case of these prices. But the metals as a space also has started on a weaker note. You have the gold prices trading in the negative in the Shanghai markets, even as you have seen the China PMI services data coming on positive for the previous month. It really hasn't done anything for the metals as a space. So we are looking at quarter and even 0.5% of a decline for most of the Shanghai metals. LME metals are trading quite flat. You want to see how the Indian prices open in that sense.
Okay, Manisha, thanks a lot for that. Looks like we are in for weak opening, and a couple of stocks which are down in pre-open. Just Dial is down 7%. So interesting, and Tata Global is actually starting 4% lower. Jet Airways as well down about 4%. SP Dulsen of SPDulsen.com now joins us. Mr. Dulsen, good morning. So, you know, we discussed it last week as well. You know, you warned about this possibility of, and you're talking about that negative list. The issue here is with this kind of downtake, 150 points now and already 250 gone on Friday, how should investors approach the market from here on?
See, Anuj, in fact, on 1st January, I said that I have a stock, we have prepared a stock list of 100 stocks. And let me say that all 100 have corrected. Now, it's only the quantum which has been, you know, because the negative list, maybe some of them still have just corrected maybe a couple of percentage on which we are keeping a check. And we have seen the correction taking place of as high as 40%, you know, which were appearing in our negative list. And in fact, day before or maybe a couple of days back, also I have warned you, you know, even prior to this PC Jeweler meltdown, if I'm not mistaken, on Wednesday afternoon show that you scratch my back, I scratch your back. When this corporate starts investing in each other, that means you have the paucity of funds, and the funds of the company are loosely, or I would say that recklessly deployed for manipulating the share price. And that's really very dangerous. And I hope that regulator will take up this matter seriously. If they don't plug this loophole of this intra, operator play between the companies and promoter, this is going to damage the market to a great extent. And still coming on the, specifically on the market, you know, I don't think that the market will take a longer time beyond Wednesday. In fact, on Friday afternoon show, I've said that I'm expecting this weakness to continue till Wednesday, maybe Tuesday close, or maybe Wednesday during intraday. And the flow or the pace of the fall will definitely be tapered down. On Friday, we have seen Nifty falling by about 290 points. Today, we may see Nifty falling by 120, 130 points, or maybe 100 points. And tomorrow, we may see falling it by 30, 40 points. And that seems to be the climax for the weakness, you know, coming to an end, for the simple reason that the Nifty, if you really see, having risen by 575 points in this January, or maybe Sensex 1900 points in January and Bank Nifty 2800 points in January, was unwarranted. There was no reason. And even if we say that the global market up move was responsible for this, so probably the global market weakness is also making our market also to correct, which in fact I gave my view during my budget speeches at various locations, that I don't see LTCG the reason at all for this weakness. I don't find any problem with the budget. LTCG was to come, which has come. So taking this into consideration, market is likely to bottom out in my view at the Nifty and index level, probably by Wednesday close of the day. Again, we will be seeing the buying coming in with vengeance on Thursday and Friday, when again we will be seeing all the experts saying that this weakness should have been used as a buying opportunity, which is very usual seen in the hindsight being this type of view being given by majority of them. Let me tell you that very, very, very this thing. So this is excellent opportunity to mop up the quality stocks. I don't think that the mid and small cap will really be start performing even for next couple of months. And even on that also, you know, for last 1 week in all my afternoon shows, I have said that look for the mid and small cap stocks. The ideas have not gone anywhere. Still, there are many stocks which have been ruling, which are ruling at a P multiple of 8 to 12. And if you find the good promoter with good earning visibility, go and lap those mid and small cap stocks also. It reminds me of February 2016, when the similar situation was prevailing. Nobody was even prepared to touch the frontline and stocks, and we have initiated a buy call on the mid and small caps at that point of time, and those ideas have given a gain of anywhere between 100% to 900%. I'm not saying that the similar kind of returns can be expected again from mid and small cap, but you must have a mid and small cap also in your portfolio. It's only the quantum which will decide whether it is 10% or it is 25%, but it cannot be beyond 25% in the small and mid-cap stocks. You need to now focus on the large-cap and quality stocks, which itself are capable to give you a return of maybe about 12 to 15% in FY18 itself. So the current weakness, at least we have been advising our clients to go and buy the select quantity and start building up your portfolio from here on.
Okay, Mr. Tulsen, yeah, if you could advise on which are the stocks that you would advise buy at these dips?
See, again, when I said that I'll be looking for the frontliner stocks, then if I need to pick and choose, I will say that I'll go with the steel, cement and gas-based stocks. Maybe if I need to pick one or two, I won't be, maybe in steel, JSW Steel, excellent numbers. You know, the kind of performance which they have shown. We have taken a positive call on steel sector about 1 year back. And in that mid-cap category, we have already seen them giving you a gain of 500%. But market starts that one-way linear up move, which never happens with the mid and small cap. So now the steel stocks are seeing corrections. I won't name the stocks, you know, which have given the returns in the past, you know, of about 400% post our buy call having initiated on them. But as of now, JSW Steel looks an excellent stock. Maybe in cement, instead of taking a direct call on Ultratech, I'll rather go with the Grasim, which is a holding company. Maybe in the FMCG, I'll go with Godrej Consumer. Amongst the gas stocks, when you see the crude prices moving up, you have excellent opportunities. All the gas stocks, because of the pollution reason, because of the economical reason, because it is always cheaper to use the gas, you know, on the cost basis also. So maybe in that space, I'll go with the Petronet LNG, IGL and MGL, because the kind of migration, even on the domestic front, which we have been seeing happening in the tier one cities like Bombay, Delhi, where the MGL and IGL are having a very good presence. Similar is the case with Petronet LNG, having, you know, revised their contracts downward for procurement of the gas on a long-term basis with their Dahej LNG terminal operating at 110-115% capacity utilization, with capacity getting enhanced to 50 million ton. And even the Kochi terminal have started operating at 10-15%. So I think you need to pick and choose the theme. Maybe, in fact, I can add the Reliance Industries. Probably channel may be a bit uncomfortable in seeing a call on Reliance Industries, you know. But the kind of excellent numbers, you all may initiate your disclosure and, you know, of the channel that you all own the Reliance, the promoters own the Reliance Industries. But I'm purely on fundamental basis. If you really see the kind of turnaround having seen in Reliance Jio, and Reliance Industries is now ruling at a P multiple of maybe about 13-14 on an expected EP of 74 rupees for FY19. So sometimes I wonder that why these investors are not educated to look for these frontline stocks instead of lapping the mid and small caps, which are ruling at a P multiple of 20-40. And let me just tell you that as a direct investment, that I don't have any in any of those five stocks which I've said. Okay. JSW Steel, Grasim, MGL, IGL, Petronet LNG and Reliance Industries. I'm not having any direct holding, but similar buy call has been given to all our members to initiate this strategy and to follow this strategy.
Okay, Mr. Siltian, thanks a lot for stopping by and speaking about a whole host of stocks. We have just 1.5 minutes to go before the market opening. Udayan Mukherjee joins in as well. Udayan, hi, good morning. You were talking about this as to how the market will start following global cues, and lo and behold, what do investors do now?
I think wait, Sonia. You know, it's tempting to say that the first fall should be bought immediately, and that's because people have generally done that over the last 14 months and it's worked out well. But I think some things have changed, particularly in the bond market, in the global space, in the budget, all of it together. So I would not jump to the conclusion that this will be another shallow correction which needs to be bought today. I don't look at horoscopes, so I am not qualified to tell you whether the correction will end on Tuesday or Wednesday. But I think this one needs to be waited out a little bit. If you buy, you buy only quality right now, because the kind of episodes that you guys were just discussing with Vakrangee, etc., generally there is a lot of skepticism about mid-caps and small-caps because of the sharpness of the fall of the last 1 or 2 weeks. And I think that is the space which might go on to hurt. So I don't know what the Nifty does. Maybe it will find some support a couple of hundred points lower and try and consolidate. But it is the portfolios of investors, which is largely in mid-caps and small-caps, which is the key concern area as we wait through the next 2 or 3 months.
Okay, just a few seconds, Udayan, so we'll come back to you in a jiffy.